A Day in the Life by Marge Piercy. She's awakened at 4 a.m. Of course, she does not pick up, but listens through the answering machine to the male voice promising she will burn in hell. At 7, she opens her door. A dead cat is hammered onto her porch. Brown tabby, hit by a car, no collar. She hugs her own Duke of Orange. She cannot let him out. She has her car locked in a neighbor's garage, safe from pipe bombs, but she must walk there. She drives to work, a circuitous guesswork route. Outside the clinic, 3 men walk in circles with photos of 6-month fetuses. They surround her car. They are forbidden the parking lot, but police don't care. They bang on her hood. As she gets out, they bump and jostle her. One thrusts his sign into her face. She protects her eyes. Something hard strikes her back. Inside, she sighs. Turns on the lights, the air conditioning, the coffee machine. The security system is always on. The funds for teenage contraception gone into metal detectors. She answers the phone. Is this where you kill babies? The second call, a woman is weeping. The day begins. A girl raped by her stepfather, a harried mother with too many children and diabetes, a terrified teenager who does not remember how it happened, a woman with an injunction against an abuser. All day she takes their calls. All day she checks them in, takes medical histories, holds hands, dries tears, hears secrets and lies and horrors, soothes, continues. Every time a new patient walks in, a tinny voice whispers, "Is this the one carrying a handgun with an automatic weapon with a knife?" She sits exposed. She answers the phone. "I'm going to cut your throat out, you murderer. Have a nice day." A bomb threat is called in. She has to empty the clinic. The police finally come. There's no bomb. The doctor tells her how they are stalking his daughter. Then she goes home to Duke, eats late supper by the TV. Her mother calls. Her boyfriend comes over. She cries in his arms. He is, she can tell, getting tired of her tears. Next morning, she rises and day falls on her like a truckload of wet cement. This is a true story. This is what I know of virtue. This is what I know of goodness in our time.